Guys, it's David Kwan. So once again, I haven't been on YouTube in a minute. A long minute. It's a saying. People say that here, or I don't know where actually it is. Is it an East Coast thing? I'm on the East Coast. But people say that, you know, we haven't seen each other in a minute. What they really mean is that, you know, they haven't seen each other in a long time. It's like saying, hey, give me a second while I'm doing this. But it doesn't mean giving them a second, because if you actually just give them a second, then the second is over. Anyway, the long digression aside, I haven't been on YouTube in a long while. And at least this time, my hiatus, I'll call it that, my hiatus wasn't for like 3 months. That's happened before. And thankfully, not as long as over a year, because one time I think I haven't been on YouTube for like over a year. So this is a really bad pattern I have with making blogs on YouTube. If YouTube and I were actually dating, then she'd probably be puzzled and upset. That, you know, I have this habit of being regularly committed to her for a long while, and then all of a sudden I just stop texting her and calling her. Once in a while she'll call me and I'll answer the phone, that's and then I'll, you know, talk on the phone. That's like, you know, somebody watching my videos, leaving a comment or emailing me after watching a video, and I'll respond. That's kind of it, but I mean, I'm not making videos for a long time. That's the metaphor. And in this metaphor, at least YouTube can't break up with me. Well, I mean, as long as I don't dump her, like, you know, cancel my channel. And as long as I don't put up any copyright material for which Google will probably ban my channel if I do too much of that. And yeah, that would be a pretty painful breakup. I think I figured it out, though, why I go on these YouTube hiatuses. It always seems to start when I think to myself, I'm gonna start writing for and plan for my blogs. Most of my videos, after all, on this channel, like almost all of them, it's just me getting in front of my MacBook camera, clicking record, and just blabbering on my thoughts. I don't really take the time or the effort to edit anything. They're all unedited almost all the time. If I mess up, like during recording, if I really mess up, then I'll just delete that and I'll re-record myself without, you know, not wanting the hassle of editing stuff that I already, you know, did. And then I upload that to YouTube and do something else while it takes a long time for it to finish uploading. That's my usual YouTube blogging process. And that's how it always has been for so many videos. And I have over 1,000 of them, you know? It's pretty crazy. That probably explains why so many of my videos are like over 10 minutes long and don't really cover much ground and often lack focus. So, you know, that's why I get to thinking that my videos would be better if I actually write down what I'm going to say. I mean, I still won't really have to edit, but with the script, there's much, much less chance to mess up. The only real worry is that it would feel too forced and not authentic, like it shows that I'm reading off a prompt or something like that. So, you know, I start jotting out all these ideas for videos I want to make. They're mostly about video games I played, movies I watched, stuff like that. You know, that's how this channel started. Some ideas I will categorize as communism, you know, pun on my last name. And, you know, those videos are just about my life, the thoughts I have, some real life issues and things like that. I still have a lot of those ideas. You know, a lot of the views that I got, you know, was when I talked about my student debt, when I talked about kind of the gay marriage debate, things like that. You know, I just try to think of the ideas to do. I try to make a schedule to start writing. Only the problem is the writing usually doesn't ever happen. I end up procrastinating on that, and as I procrastinate on that, I of course end up procrastinating on producing anything for my YouTube channel, and hence the hiatus. It'll take weeks or months or even up to a year, because yeah, that happened, before I break the hiatus by again just getting in front of the camera and hitting record. I look back and, you know, this hiatus pattern has always happened after I started thinking about writing a script for my videos. Not that I haven't ever written a script. I mean, this video right now, I'm reading up a script. You could probably tell. And there have been a couple of other ones, mainly my earlier videos. I mean, way earlier, like back in 2008 or 2009 or something like that. Man, I sure have been on YouTube for a long time. Hopefully, now that I realize the source of this issue, maybe and hopefully, that means that this hiatus is now over for good, and then I make videos for this channel more regularly. Will the videos be any good? That I can't really guarantee. You'll get the same kind of stuff as before, just me talking in front of the camera, almost always unedited, and mostly unscripted. that's just how I roll, I guess. That's definitely how I'll be for my Bible blogs. And yep, I'm still going to continue doing that, going through the entirety of the Holy Bible and sharing my thoughts on it. At this point, I'm still at the middle of Leviticus. No, wait, did I? I have to check back on that. No, I think I'm at Numbers now. I'm past Numbers. Man, I haven't done them in such a long time. Done them in a while, and if I'm still at Numbers, yeah, that means I'm nowhere near done with the project. And that's probably why a lot of the Christians who watch those videos are usually like, well, actually, I don't know if they watch them. I get the feeling that they watch the title that somebody is reading to or responding to the Bible, and they figure out this person doing that is an atheist, and then that's when they get to the comment section, and they'll write, you should have started with the New Testament, or skip the Old Testament, and do the New Testament instead, and things like that, because it's going to take a long, long time to get through the Old Testament books. And the Christians, what they're concerned with is that I get to Jesus, and accepting Jesus Christ as one and only Savior, and being a Christian, and all that. So, Old Testament is kind of irrelevant to Christianity. But, I mean, the Bible is an important book, so that's why I'm going to go through it all. It's going to take a long, long time, but that's my intention, to go through that entire gigantic text, you know, verse by verse. I'm going to skip some chapters where all it does is, like, name the names of descendants. It does that a lot sometimes. Not a lot, but some chapters are like, this is the name of so-and-so. Who was the son of so-and-so? And he was blah, blah, blah. Who was the son of so-and-so? He would live to be this year. The Bible has some of those chapters. Yeah, I've skipped a couple of them in my project. Because, I mean, yeah. The Bible can be very boring, especially those chapters can be quite boring. But I don't consider the entire Bible as boring. Now I'm going off my prompt here, and you can probably tell because I'm more conversational and probably, hopefully, more natural and more, I say and you know a lot when I go off the prompt. That's just kind of how I am, you know. See, I did it, you know. Anyway, I think Bible is a fascinating book, and that's why it has had a huge impact on my life. You know, I've been Christian for over 17 years, if you count from the time I was born till I turned 17. It has such a huge impact. So I'm revisiting it and reflecting back on the text that has such a huge impact on my life. That's really all I'm doing. I'm reading it or having it heard, read to me. And then I respond to it now with the self that I am. I'm guessing it'll take years, and after some time, many of those videos will likely become obsolete as my understanding and critiquing of the text gets wiser and more complicated. That has happened. This is my fourth time reading the Bible from the beginning to the end. And the first two times I did as a devout born-again Christian, the third time is the time that, you know, I lost my faith. But anyway, in either case, you know, I'm sure I'll feel like I achieved something really big if I do end up completing the project. And then afterwards, I don't know, go after Book of Mormon or the Quran? Though at this point, maybe that's looking way too far ahead. Before this most recent hiatus, I uploaded my very first part of me playing Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. It's an interesting game. And me being a huge Metal Gear fan, I figured I have a lot of comments as I played through it. Which I did. I used my iPad to record, and I recently also updated my iMovies on my MacBook. The problem is that my MacBook is way too old and too weak to handle the updated iMovies app. The iMovies on my MacBook crashes a lot, like all the time. And it takes so long to export movie files I edited. So, unfortunately, I give up. At least for now. On doing any playthroughs or I think on YouTube land we call them Let's Plays. I was hoping to kind of get back in the groove of doing Let's Plays because it's really fun actually playing them and commenting on as I play and sharing my thoughts on the entirety of the game and then uploading that to YouTube. That's still like a really thing that I really enjoyed, but to do them, I need much better equipment, much better computer, probably a better recording thing. I have a recording a capture device, but it captures SD footage, and I really do not want to, you know, play with component cables on my PS3 just to record, because I think I've now gotten the habit of playing games in HD. That's crazy, because, you know, 3 years ago, I didn't really care. You know, I was playing PS3 games on, you know, component cables, and I was okay with that. Now, like, don't really want to do that. But these are huge files now because they're HD files. So at this point, you know, can't really afford to do that. If I have extra $1,000 here, which probably won't happen until way down the line, then yeah, sure, I'll maybe do Let's Plays. But then maybe I'll get too old to do them by that point. You know, I think as people get older, their interest in video games kind of start to fade. I don't know. I have no idea whether it'll be true or not. Maybe I'll be 50 years old and I'll still be playing with the controller or whatever. Or Oculus Rift virtual reality stuff. I have no idea. Maybe Kinect version 4.0, although this is a digression. I'm totally going off my prompt now. Actually have not played or done anything with Kinect. I have no idea how that plays. Although, from what I've read on the interwebs and heard and watched blogs, people say it's kind of just what no one wants. But who knows? Maybe 20 years from now, it could mean something. Don't know. Or maybe we'll just probably be playing with a controller with buttons and sticks because we are old-fashioned. Or video game market crashed and there's just no video games anymore. Future is up for grabs. I do have a lot of time now, though. I just finished my first year as a graduate student, and I don't really have much plans for the summer, other than studying on my own. That I need to do more of now. I haven't really done that recently, but yeah, that's on the plan. I'm gonna prepare for my second year graduate school, my final year graduate school, on my own this summer. I really need to prepare better. But, you know, in the meanwhile, with my free time, I'm, of course, going to be playing a lot of video games, hanging out with my friends over the weekends. And I've also been, recently, I've been binge-watching House. Like, I started, like, literally from season 1, and now I'm at season 6. Like, over the past, I started, like, 2 or 3 weeks ago. So I've been really watching a lot of House. Like, so much House. It's just, House is on my brain so much right now. And at this point, I'm kind of getting, I'm beyond that. I'm beyond annoyed with this kind of formulaic nature, but I'm still very much hooked on it. Anyway, my point is that it's now summer vacation for me, and I have quite a good amount of free time. So if I'm not making videos here, time wouldn't be the issue. It's probably that I'm just being too lazy. Hopefully, I don't end up being too lazy, because I have a pretty good list of all the different kinds of blogs and videos I want to put up here. Will they be any good? I'm not sure, but I just enjoy doing these for whatever reason. Sometimes I have a fluke. By a fluke, I mean a video that has a ridiculous amount of views. It's rare that happens, and it's even more rare that people have a lot of comments on those videos. For some reason, people like to watch and click like, there's a video that I've seen on YouTube where it's just like hundreds of thousands of views, but it has like 5 comments. That's interesting. So I appreciate comments more than views. You know, people, I don't really care how many people watch my video. Wait, no, that's not true. I do care, because it makes me feel good, I guess, that so many people watch my videos. I feel good, and at the same time, I also feel kind of insecure. Like, oh my gosh, so many people watch this video. And this video is kind of crap looking back on it. Like, the most talked about, the most discussed video on my channel is the $100,000 student debt video that I ended up making. I guess it's a big hit because I don't know. Well, the title is rather clickbait worthy. You know, it's kind of catchy. Somebody who, the most common type of comment I get is like this stupid person who majored in social work and a bachelor's in social work ended up with such a humongous debt. That's probably the thing. Although, when I made it, I think my line of thinking was there's going to be a lot of people in a similar situation. The average student debt at this point is like $30,000 or something like that. So yeah, $100,000 is ridiculous. But I also know a lot of my colleagues or a lot of other students in many other fields, and you know, in private university and things like that, for bachelors that go well above $100,000. And if you watch that video, you'll know that I ended up with $105,000 because, you know, it could have been much higher. It actually, without all the support that I got, it actually should have been like $160,000 in debt or something like that. But I had scholarships, my first year was paid for, and all that. Now I'm repeating the same video that I made before. But that got like a ridiculous amount of hits. My Popo LaCroix video, for some reason, is a fluke. Most of my videos don't get that many views, don't get many comments. Or sometimes I get very few views, but we end up having an amazing discussion in the comment section, which I always appreciate. I love those. And actually, I am surprised that few people have reached out to me, like email. I've been having really good personal communication with them, and it actually ended up to being something much more meaningful for me, at least. You know, one of those email correspondents. So that's amazing. Anyway, that's kind of all I wanted to say in this video. I want to make more, and even with the prompt, I ended up over 60 minutes. So I guess prompt isn't a good way of cutting down the length of the video. I just talk a lot. I just write a lot. That's just kind of how I am, I suppose. For now, cheers, and cross your fingers that I don't go into another one of my YouTube hiatus. If you care enough, that is. Cheers.